Hello, boys and girls. I wonder if you can think of a promise that someone has made to you. Whenever I was about 6 or 7, I wasn't very brave and I wasn't very adventurous. In fact, lots of things scared me. And one day I went to Coco's Adventure Playground in Newcastle. Maybe some of you have been there. And everything scared me. I didn't want to go on the big slides because they were far too scary. Well, my mum knew that it wasn't so good for me to be just so scared of things like that. And she knew that I would be safe and that nothing would happen to me and that it might be good for me to do something that scared me. So she made me a promise. She said, if you have a go at that slide, then you can choose something as a treat. Well, I thought about this and I knew I was scared, but I'd also been to the toy shop and I had seen a Playmobil camper van. It was brilliant. It had little bicycles, little deck chairs. It was great. And I said, could I maybe get the Playmobil camper van? And Mum said, yeah, you can. So I had a go at the slide and actually it wasn't so bad after all. Do you think my mum kept her promise? She did. And actually the Playmobil camper van still exists. I had to look for it in the garage and I had to give it a bit of a wash, but here it is. My mum kept her promise. Now sometimes we make promises that we can't keep. Sometimes we make promises that we don't keep because we forget about them. There are lots of reasons why we make promises and don't keep them. But the Bible tells us that God always keeps his promises. Now I'm going to read a verse from the Bible and I want you to listen out for the word beginning with, what letter are we on now? Yes, the letter F. So this is Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 9. Know therefore that the Lord your God is God, the faithful God who keeps covenant and steadfast love with those who love him and keep his commandments to 1,000 generations. Did you hear the word? Faithful. God is faithful. That means he always keeps his promises. In the book of Genesis, at the very beginning of the Bible, we read the story of a man called Abraham. And God said to Abraham, I want you to leave the country that you're living in now and go to a place that I'm going to show you. And God said, from your family is going to come a great nation, lots and lots and lots of people. And because of your family, all the families in the world are going to be blessed. Now, that means that something good was going to come from Abraham's family that would be for everybody. And God said to Abraham, look at the stars up in the sky. Can you count them? Well, I couldn't count all the stars in the sky. Nobody can count all the stars in the sky. And God said to Abraham, your descendants, the people that come from your family, there's going to be more of them than there are stars in the sky. But there was a bit of a problem. Because Abraham and his wife Sarah, they didn't have any children. And they were very, very old. But Abraham knew that God keeps his promises and Abraham trusted God. And we read about how Abraham and his wife Sarah, even though they were very old, they had a son called Isaac because God keeps his promises. And then when Isaac had children and grandchildren, they had children and grandchildren, of course, Abraham's family got bigger and bigger. And whenever we read of the children of Israel, we read about them, we've heard about them in Sunday school, about how God rescued them from Egypt, about how they crossed the Red Sea whenever God created a path through the sea for them. They're all from Abraham's family because God keeps his promises. From Abraham's family came a great nation. And there was another part to that promise that God gave Abraham. God said, from your family is going to come something or someone that will be a blessing to everyone. And God keeps his promises. Because many, 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 many years later, through Abraham's family, God sent Jesus to rescue his people from their sin. God is faithful and he keeps his promises. In the same way as God kept his promises to Abraham, God keeps his promises to us as well. Because God is faithful, he does exactly what he says he will do. Now that means that when we read in the Bible that anyone who hasn't trusted in Jesus to forgive them for their sins will be separated from God, that's exactly what will happen because God does what he says he will do. But he has given us an amazing promise. He has promised that if we ask him to forgive us for our sin, if we're really sorry for those wrong things that we have thought and said and done, then he's not going to turn us away. He's not going to say, no, go away, I won't forgive you. No, he will forgive us. And we can be accepted into God's family and know that we have a home in heaven someday. What an amazing promise. God keeps his promises. But whenever we have trusted God to forgive us for our sins, the promises don't end there, because God has promised that he will never leave us. He will always be there with us, no matter where we are or no matter what is happening. And he has also promised that he will help us each day to grow to be a little bit more like Jesus. And how does that happen? Well, it happens as we listen to the Bible being taught to us. It happens as we read the Bible for ourselves. It happens as we talk to God. It happens as we meet with our church family and help each other to love Jesus more. And God has promised that that process will continue until the day that we go to heaven to be with him forever. Now, there were times whenever Abraham maybe forgot that God always keeps his promises. There were times that Abraham disobeyed God. Do you think that meant that God stopped being faithful to him because he disobeyed? No, of course not, because God is always faithful, even when we are not. Imagine that you go out to play football in your garden, but your mum or dad said, please don't play too close to the house because there's lots of windows and you know what could happen. But whenever you go outside, you think, oh, but it's a great shot. Oh, I could do it. Nobody will ever know. You take your shot and smash, the window breaks. Now, you have disobeyed an instruction. You've disobeyed your mum or dad. Do you think that means that they say, no, you're not part of our family anymore? Of course not. You're still part of the family. But of course, things might not be so good in your house for a while until you go and say, I'm really sorry for what I have done because I have disobeyed you. It's really important that you go and you say that you're sorry for disobeying your mum or dad. It's the same for us and God. If we disobey him, it's important that we talk to him about it. It's important that we say that we are sorry so that that sin doesn't spoil our friendship that we have with God. It doesn't mean that we're not part of his family anymore, but it's important that we talk to God about it and that we tell him that we're sorry for disobeying him. So today I want us all to remember that God keeps his promises. He is faithful, even when we are not. Next week, we're going to come back and look at another really brilliant promise that God has given to us. I'll talk to you soon.